messages, like I said, they're all pointing the finger at each other.
They both have just put Eric Bischoff right squarely in the middle.
Brother, you got a choice to make tonight, and you're not gonna have all these people around here to pull me off you. So you better go back and get ready, big man. And by the way, all these other problems that haven't been taken care of, there's a reason this man is with me. And you should watch how this brother handles serious business. And you, Mr. Bischoff, better take heed, because he's here for a reason.
Last Monday night, in the Georgia Dome, that coward, Diamond Dallas Page, took a chair to the back of my head and left me with 47 stitches, and he didn't get the job done. In other words, because I'm still here. So tonight, like Hollywood said, we're going to take care of the family business. So you coward, Dallas Page, if you got any guts in your body at all, then you will meet me tonight in the ring so we can settle this thing once and for all. Because that little apocalypse, that little thing I gave you last night in San Diego was nothing compared to what I'm gonna do to you tonight, right here in Las Vegas.
Now that's
and
a gamble.
Nobody else is gonna be there but just me and you. So if you got the guts, then get in the ring.
The way it goes, it's real simple. NWO Black and White rules. We're gonna find out who For Life is tonight.
Shot at the title. Hollywood's got the power, I've got the money, and I've got the backing. In other words, brah, you don't want to mess with Mother Nature.
But you know something, Kevin? All those power bombs that I paid for, 50 grand to pop, 25, 30 of them, well, I called my attorney, brother, and you, hey, bite me, you know? I heard that, Rod. Wow, ouch.
Higher.
Wow. Point taken. Kevin Nash, 25, 30 power bombs, 50 grand a pop. I called my attorney, Henry Holmes, the real NWO attorney. We're going to collect tonight, brother, and we're going to collect on you, Kevin Nash, because you owe me a lot of money.
Tell the good part.
Oh, the good part. Here's the good part, you know. Lawsuit. I like that. You know, let me tell him. Rodzilla, the big surprise. Somebody you haven't seen yet, brother, that's on the team. NWO Hollywood, the newest superstar to hit the big screen. The man who's going to rock the world, brother. Just wait till he sees him, Mr. Bischoff.
Didn't you tell me, Hollywood, that he was going to be the second biggest name in Hollywood? Is that what you told me?
Second biggest, brother. And wait till they see Leah, they're gonna just totally freak out.
Kevin Nash, you made your bed, and now you're gonna live in it, and we'll be more than happy to live in ours. Hollywood, you are the man. Rodzilla, thanks for coming tonight. Thanks for bringing the talent.
Where'd you get the talent, bro?
Come on, man, look at this. You gotta love this. This is life, right? For life, forever, baby. Hey, right here.
Bag, baby. You know, there are some things worth missing practice for, brother. And, and that's definitely the NWO, brother.
Whoa. Area right here at the dressing room of Rowdy Roddy Piper. Welcome to my hometown, Minneapolis and St. Paul. Great to have you here for tonight.
Gonna be a hot time in St. Paul and Minneapolis tonight. I tell you, what we have tonight is we're gonna have those two two troublemakers. We're going to get Nash and Hogan. I'm so sick and tired of listening to them whine and dine each other. Then the next time they're signing prenuptial agreements, I'm going to have them wrestle each other one-on-one tonight in Minneapolis. Number two, after that's finished, I'm coming to Hogan myself, and I'm going to stare him eye to eye, and I am going to rid the wrestling world of Hulk Hogan. I am tired, sick and tired of all the shenanigans that Hogan has pulled with Savage, ruining Savage's leg.
Hey, get him out of here!
Incredible turn of events, a brutal attack by Hollywood Hogan.
Where'd they come from?
And the Disciple.
Three, Brutus Beefcake rolls him up. Got him.
Hey, Ed.
Hey, Mr.
Sorry, man. Hey, pull up a chair, please. Come on, Ed. Hey, you know what this is?
It's like my contract.
Yeah. You know, I couldn't help but notice that in 30 days, the contract expires. And I actually was kind of concerned about your post-wrestling career. What you got in mind?
What are you saying?
I'm asking what you got in mind for yourself when you can't wrestle anymore for our company. When this expires in 30 days.
Well, you know, I was kind of hoping to sit down and talk with you about that.
Well, that's why I asked you to come in, because I wanted to talk to you, too. Let me ask you a question. How long have you been knowing Hulk Hogan? Hollywood
Hulk Hogan?
Yeah.
20-something years, man.
Yeah, I saw you guys come through Atlanta, early 80s, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, we knew Hogan when he wasn't much at all, didn't we?
Before he was anything, brother.
So now Hogan has been the Mac Daddy for a long time, right?
That's true.
Yeah, much to the dismay of both of us, probably, if you're honest with yourself.
Yeah. He's the man?
Yeah. Well, no, he's not the man. He was the man. I'm the man right now. And I'm holding your paper.
Everybody knows you're the man, brother.
Thank you. Well, this moment I am. Be assured. And let me tell you what I'm looking at. Somehow Hogan got his hand raised last Monday night, and he won the right to wrestle me at Spring Stampede for the world title. But as you probably know, the scuttlebutt is that I'm trying to make it rough on him between now and then. Well, here's how rough I'm gonna make it. I'm gonna take this contract, and you got a beautiful wife, a new baby, and I'm gonna roll this deal over, which means I'm gonna extend it for 3 more years, for twice that figure. Oh. And all you gotta do.
Tell me, man. What do I gotta do?
Is beat Hulk Hogan. Hey, you gotta wrestle Hogan. Tonight? I'm Thunder. Yeah. Twice this number for 3 years. And all you gotta do is beat Hulk.
Twice that money.
Beat Hogan. I wouldn't put much thought in this. I'd act fast. The opportunity might not be here in a couple minutes. What do you think?
I'll do it.
Done deal?
I got no choice. I gotta do it.
You're right. You don't have a choice. It's 3 years at double the money if you beat Hogan tonight. Or it's sayonara. You gonna do it?
I bet I'm gonna do it.
Don't let your family down. Don't let me down.
Got a lot riding on this match.
Don't let the business down.
All right, Mr. Flair.
Tonight.
I'm your man.
Opportunity's there, pal. Get it.
Right.
You never liked Hogan that much anyway. Think about it. Be honest with yourself. Come on.
The action continues live from Richmond, Virginia, the Coliseum. This is Thunder.
I am your leader, your boss. And I am your world champion. You keep your mouth shut, fat boy. I'll take your girlfriend home, make a woman out of her, man. Tonight, right here, baby, in Richmond, VA, long, shut up! long before you get to me, you gotta wrestle Ed. Come on out here, Ed Leslie. Come on. Come on. Right here. Yeah, you.
Oh, this is a low blow. This is a low blow, Flair.
You have to wrestle him. And you know what? He's going to be glad to walk that aisle and kick your butt. Right, Ed?
Hollywood, this goes beyond personal. This goes beyond business. This is the future of the disciple, all riding tonight on this match. So I'm gonna make sure that you go down.
Your best friend is gonna walk down here because I say so and kick your butt tonight. You got it?
We know I'm glad he came out from under the rock.
You got it?
He was hiding
you
under.
Got it? Tonight.
Because now,
tonight.
Business is business.
Tonight, 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 you're dead.
Would you please give us a break here? That incessant talking.
You keep your mouth shut, punk.
Well, there he's going after some fans in the crowd here tonight.
You know something, Flair? I don't care who I have to step on, especially the man that just came out from under the rock. At the end of the day, Flair, in Stampede, I will still be in your face, and that belt will be mine. Come on, disciple. We can do this thing right now if you want to.
How about that? Hogan is not backing down, Tony. And there's a little exchange. Maybe it's going to be more than rhetoric, though.
Now we know it's going to be a match tonight. Hogan and the disciple.
You want me to have you thrown out of here? Get out of the building! Get out of my building! Get out of my building now! Get out! Get out of my building! Shut up! Talking to you! Shut up, you! Get out of my building!
Well, wow. He's the prez. He can do that.
Talk about power hungry.
I don't think he can
building.
Do that.
I'm the boss!
He's
get out of my building!
Gene, does Hollywood want to say anything else here?
Hollywood. Look at what this man is doing to you, to me, to everybody in this building tonight.
It's strictly business, brother. And as long as the wool pack's intact, I'll jump through the next hoop to get the Flair. I'm gonna go back and get my head right. The party starts when Hollywood comes back out.
All right, still to come, it's gonna be Hollywood Hogan and the Disciple right here, center.
First in Hollywood's transmission tonight, he agreed to face this man, his longtime former associate, Ed Leslie, the Disciple.
The Disciple comes in, and we throw another wild card into the deck here, fans, and that is the wild card by the name of Sting. Certainly, whenever he makes an appearance, he has been a vital part of the title scene, a vital part of any scene in World Championship Wrestling. His special message to all of us, to the world, will come forth Monday on Nitro, live from the MGM Grand in Las Vegas. What will that be? And what impact will it have on Hollywood Hogan, on President Ric Flair? If we'll recall, as here he comes, the man with those pythons, those 24-inch pythons, one of the greatest physiques ever in pro wrestling. Remember when Sting made his appearance, Flair's reaction? It was almost as if Flair was angered that Sting had made an appearance and had really not let the president know.
Well, the president should know. If you were the president, you'd want to know.
Sure,
wouldn't you?
Absolutely, I agree.
Well, I can understand how the man could be offended. See, Sting just can't come out of the rafters or up to some sewer with a different piece of face paint on and start getting in people's way and making people wonder what the heck he's up to. He wants to talk to somebody, talk to him.
All right, the bell sounds. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Main event time here on Thunder. Here on TBS, and the Disciple doing the bidding of the president, Ric Flair, against Hollywood Hogan. I think if there's any two men who know each other in this sport on a personal level, I'm not so sure a wrestling level, it's these two men. Of course, it's not the first time these two men have met, Mike.
No, it certainly isn't, Tony, in terms of one-on-one competition or even together as a tag team. So you are 100% right. They should know each other better than just about anyone else in the locker room.
Since Hogan's hit, crashing to the top turnbuckle, now to the other side. Hogan hit the back very hard, and the Disciple goes in with a hard right hand.
Disciple's staying on him right from the beginning.
Hogan holds his ground. The Disciple goes in, and Hogan
pins him in the corner of the lariat. Hogan measures him with a right hand. Hollywood Hogan. What a storied career he has had in this sport, undeniably. Knife-edge chop on the disciple. And Hogan has turned right around, has taken the offense right to the disciple. He is always, though, throughout his career as Hogan, but a very offensive wrestler. Short elbow drop. And did not give a hook, and he gets a one. And you have to wonder the mixed emotions that could possibly be going through the mind of Hollywood Hogan here. I mean, I know that he and the disciple have had their problems as of late, as of the last year, but they have always been so close. Hogan realized what this is all about, and I wonder how he feels about it. Well, maybe he's going to give us an answer. He doesn't take that belt off for just anyone.
Well, during that interview, he said it was time to put emotions aside. This is strictly business. And now the disciple takes the weightlifting belt away from Hogan and just nailed him with it twice.
On the outside, Hogan's going to draw him out there and nail him with a right hand once again. Look at Hogan. Look at his face. He seems very confident, in command here. Let's hear that again.
Oh,
thank you.
Just peeling the skin right off of the disciple's back.
He's got a big enough back.
Around the mouth, the throat of the disciple, head first to the steel ring post. Hollywood in charge on the outside, and Hollywood nails him. He goes back on the inside. This is our main event on Thunder. As we await to see what will transpire Monday on Nitro, look at the disciple come back with a couple of right hands, a scoop slam to put him down. And drives, it's a chokehold here.
Sudden surge of energy, the scoop and the slam, and then follows up with that blatant chokehold, just throttling Hogan right in front of the official, but Hogan cut him off at the pass.
Certainly, of the two men, of the two friends, Hogan has had the most success, but you can't count the disciple out. He certainly has been a champion over and over again in this sport. He's a great veteran, a fine competitor. One, two.
And the Hogan's had a lot of great success because he's used a lot of people.
And so you're saying there's something wrong with that. That's
no.
Not like you.
I just don't like him using people. I don't like anybody else using people. I just don't like the guy.
Here's a pickup and a belly to back. Dropped him on the back of the head. Hogan will float over for the cover. And he got a two. So now Hollywood Hogan tries a different approach here to the disciple. What's he going to do now? He's going to pick, no. Schoolboard him up, one and two. But he's on the ropes. So again, that's the veteran and the disciple coming out here. Hogan. Oh, the disciple fired back once again, guys. Look at this. He will not be deterred. The disciple has come out with a purpose here.
Whoa. Whoa! Took him over. Show of strength by the disciple with the suplex. Quick cover.
Made a cover, but could not get a pin count. And the disciple, the first man back. We are seeing the disciple wrestle with some sort of purpose here tonight. But Hollywood Hogan comes back again. Snap him over. And Hogan stumps on the head of the disciple. Is he begging off or not?
He's nope. Trying to see.
That's exactly what he's doing. He goes into the ropes. Hogan ducks low. The disciple with an uppercut. Not a bad move at all. Can he follow it up, though? Went into the throat. He'll jam him in the throat again.
Well, we talked earlier about how these wrestlers would know each other's moves. Perfect example of that, telegraphing the back body drop. The Russian leg sweep by the disciple. But Hogan gets to his feet.
Hogan has popped up.
Seen that before.
Yes, and so has everyone around the world. Here he comes. The Hollywood Hogan. Come back. He's on.
Oh.
The big foot. We've got something. It's Ric Flair.
Flair's out.
He tripped up Hogan as Hogan. Obviously, Mike was going for the big leg drop.
He was on the verge of victory. There's the apocalypse from the disciple.
That's his move. That's it. And he got up from it.
Flair's. Hogan is up. Hogan is on his feet.
And Flair couldn't believe it. He runs over. There's the big leg. Flair is in. And Mickey Jacobs. And Flair. Whoa. That's the ref.
member of the Wolfpack is out.
Yo, and don't...
Oh, go ahead, Johnny. Don't...
What?
I have a little...
I have some... Yeah. I have
you know, What I was going to say real quick is that the Disco Inferno has really impressed me lately. At the beginning, I thought the guy was just a wannabe, but he's proven himself to the red and black. He deserves his spot. Go ahead, Tony.
Can I read my promos here?
Oh, you got to read your stuff. I don't.
That's a fact. This coming Tuesday, the 23rd of March on QVC, get ready for WCW on QVC, 9 to 11 p.m. And guess who's going to be the special guest?
On QVC this Tuesday?
What do you on QVC, what do you think I just read? On QVC this Tuesday is going to be the special guest.
How about Sting?
Hey, there you go. Sting, there's been a Sting sighting. Yes, he is alive, and he will be at QVC this coming Tuesday. Should be exciting. You're going to have starter jackets and apparel, videos, die-cast cars, autographed collectible Beanie Bambinos. That's right. That's what the copy says. Beanie Bambino.
Oh, he's a cook in Uncle Louie's Italian Sportatorium.
Hard hats and other good stuff. So tune in to QVC. It's the Disciple and the Disco Inferno. Should be a great matchup here. These two guys, Mike, today we've talked about this a lot in the back, have basically the same type of move to end matches, finishing maneuvers, if you will.
Very similar with Disco's Last Dance and the Disciple's Apocalypse move. And, you know, not only in terms of finishing maneuvers, but I think some might say there are amazing parallels between these two in terms of, say, what Disco's role is now and what the Disciple's role has been in the past.
Well, I think the Disciple has a big advantage here. He's been in the sport longer. He's been in some big, big money matches. He's made his mark in professional wrestling. But this girl's got that something. You know what I mean? He's just got that oomph, that charisma, that spark that you need to make it to the top. Plus, he's got a lot of help with the NWO red and black.
And, of course, the Disciple has kind of been out there floundering around, not really knowing his identity. That does not take away from the fact that he is a fine pro wrestler. Full-arm dragon twist. Look at that. Right on target. Sends Disco Inferno right off his feet, Mike.
But I think what you're saying, Tony, is that in terms of backup, in terms of aligning himself with one of the groups within the WCW or NWO organization, he really has no allegiance with anyone else. He's alone. He's solo.
Nothing wrong with that, to be solo, to be your own man. We need more of that in the sport, actually. Full-on dragon twist. Drive dead on the arm. Textbook maneuver right here. It comes right up with an arm bar, does the Disciple.
Tony, if you're a young wrestler starting out today, and you too, Mike, had an opportunity to join the red and black, black and white, or WCW, what would you do, Mike?
Well, I think you'd have to think about the tradition and the accomplishments of World Championship Wrestling and what the WCW organization has accomplished over a longer time period than any other group.
Okay, Mike. What about you, Tony?
I'd be my own man to start out with, Brie.
Yeah, well, I'd work for all three and try to get the best offer.
You would. Here's a pickup. You're in it for the scam, right? For the dough.
No, I want to be slammed by a bunch of big guys with sweaty hands. That's what I'm in it for.
He went for his move that time, over the shoulder. He called it the Apocalypse, and the Disco Inferno saw it coming, scooted on the outside at times.
He ain't gonna beat me with my move.
He's ain't gonna get me with my move?
That's what he said. Yes. Ain't gonna beat me with my move.
Okay. Comes in the inside once again, the Disco Inferno. A part of that Wolfpack that's been so dominant. I mean, you gotta say, fans, that since the insurgence of the New World Order, that wrestling has never been the same. Head first. Ric Flair making strides to make sure their power has been cut off, but I don't know if you can do that or not, because every time something happens to them, they rebound in some grand style. Back elbow. Down goes the Disciple. And look at the Disco Inferno just wanting the man to get up. He goes in for his move, Dumick.
No.
Disciple shrugged him off, sending him into the corner. Wow. Atomic drop.
What Disciple did there is he set him up for that move. He fed himself to Disco. Disco thought he had him, but he never had him.
Hit the ropes, runs right over the Disco Inferno, so the Disciple now will make a cover and a quick one. One, two, but Disco gets out. Not a bad attempt that time to quickly try to win the match. You know, you don't always have to use your finishing maneuver, what the fans and the wrestlers know you by, to get a win. Try something different for a change, and that's what he did right there. The disco struts, stomps over to a corner, using up a lot of time. That cost him.